So next up, we have a very special performance, the spoken word piece by Lucy. So please give it up for her.
Hi. I would like to say a massive thank you to Ed and Luna for not only holding this march, but they are the reason why I'm here today. I saw Ed's speech last year, the one that he did at the march, and it was instantaneous for me. It's not enough to not eat them and not wear them. We have to use our voices. And activism is so rewarding because not only do you not contribute towards it, but you are striving to prevent it from happening. I still have them days where I feel hopeless, and that is exactly why I wrote this. And it's just a poem just expressing my passion for this movement. It breaks my heart, no exaggeration, to see the way that we treat animals as a world, as a nation. It is your duty, your obligation to go vegan. This has to stop. No negotiations. Or this world will not experience future generations. Vegans are pushy and use intimidation, but we do our best to hold back frustration. Sometimes it is desperation. Slit throats, castrations, and mutilations. This has existed before every movement, the whole duration. All aboard the train of death, the slaughterhouse is the next station. Is this how we treat God's beautiful creations? Their life is more important than your temptation. Join this movement, let's get in formation. The cracks are building in your excuses, foundations. Freedom is not a privilege, it is a birthright. Not only intended for humans, so let's just recite. Thou shalt not kill! Show. tragic view. Animals trapped in a prison disguised as a zoo, except the only crime that they have ever committed was being born. One day the sun will rise over.